Leeward initially started the fight by trying to paw and be active, circular movements with the lead hand, and then trying to switch up the variety of the lead hand and the activity of it. The problem was Rhys Mould, you see here, his lead foot, very heavy, stepping in heavy, and being able to cover that distance. Now, Leeward initially wasn't comfortable with what he was trying to do, and he was posing and posturing, as Ben Davison said to him in the corner. You could see Rhys Mould was being able to close that distance by pushing off his back foot and covering the distance with his front foot. That heavy front foot was enabling him to land that power jab, allowing him to go to the body and land that overhand right or the straight right. And as you'll see in a moment, this left hook as well. He was covering the distance and it was resulting for Leeward to push him off. But Leeward's always had a habit also of pulling back with his chin. It's a sort of angle thing to do. But as soon as Lee started to hold his feet and put his hands together and go to the body, you saw the class. You saw how he hurt Rhys, landing shots body to head and then punching through the target viciously and switching it up. He's a fantastic offensive fighter. You'll see here how he leads the check hook. He now, as the sharpness comes out of Mould's work, he was able to then walk him onto that check hook and thus get the finish. Very classy from Wood. In terms of rating the display, I'd have to say, as someone who's watched Lee Wood's career for many years, I'd say it was an average display. I've got to be critical in some regards. I felt Sky were sort of pushing this narrative that Lee Wood can't crack an egg, he's a feather duster man, and that tonight he's been able to punch hard for the first time in his career with the help of Ben Davison. It's like, well, go through his career, he stopped multiple opponents and possibly better operators than Rhys Mould. Now, Rhys Mould, I'll get onto in a moment, but I felt like Leeward early on didn't look comfortable. He had a shaky moment early in the fight when he got caught. He got buzzed. He got through it. He weathered the storm. He held his feet a little bit more. He started to switch it. In the middle rounds, he started to go southpaw. That was presenting more problems for Mould. He was going to the body. He was putting his hands together. He was starting to let the shots go. And you could see the difference in class as the fight went on. His sharpness came away. And then as the fight went on, because you've got to remember Rhys Mould hadn't been past six in his career, it started to show the sharpness went. Leeward started to hold his feet. He was then starting to evade the shots by pulling back and slipping and rolling under. He was turning him more often. He was able to walk him onto those shots. The sharpness of the front foot, which I mentioned earlier, started to go. Now he was that little bit slower, so he was getting caught by the check hook. But I do feel like Lee Wood's performance, you know, I've seen him beat better operators than that and look defensively more slicker, as per se. But he's been with Ben Davison 8 weeks, so you can't ask for too much too soon. But I'm excited to see what he will do next, because I've always been a fan of Lee Wood, but there's always been those vulnerabilities there. And it'll be interesting to see who they match him up against. But I will say this. If I was to be impressed by anyone, I'd have to say it was Rhys Mould on the night. Although he lost the fight, I felt that his ability during the fight to show courage, to get back up off the floor after a heavy knockdown. He was hurt. 10, 15, 20 seconds later, dropped heavily. He gets back up. He fights for another few rounds. He keeps pushing forward. He keeps trying. He plugged away. He got stopped. But he got stopped by a guy that had 10 years experience as a pro. He's a classy operator in Lee Wood. A guy that's an accurate puncher, who's got skill, good reflexes, and ultimately was a level above him. But there's no shame in that. Look, Lee Wood, I'm excited to see what he's going to do with Ben Davison. And Ben saying a lot of good things, and I'm excited to see their relationship. But for me, Rhys Mould showed not only courage, but early on in that fight, his jab reminded me of a young Ricky Hatton under Billy Graham. Heavy on the front foot, pushing aggressively, powerfully off the back foot, closing that distance, shooting that jab, knocking Wood's head back. Almost, you know, as I say, like a young Ricky Hatton. Obviously, Billy's been around the Josh Warrington camp with Sean O'Hagan. It makes you wonder if there's been a little bit of study going on and a little bit of work there. But brilliant, brilliant stuff to see. And I'm excited to see his future. I think he's a talent. But Lee Wood, the victor on the night, and I'm excited to see both of them. But I think both can come out of that fight with their heads held high. Anyway, guys, I'm going to leave it to you guys to put your comments in the comment section below. Please like, share, and subscribe, and comment. Let me know your thoughts on the fight. and look forward to a video that I should be doing soon on the Zelfa Barrett Kiko Martinez fight. A lot of controversy around it. Well, I want to delve into Zelfa's performance, so stay tuned.